Hello dear students, so now in this lecture we will study the very important topic of your syllabus, which is mega sporogenesis and about the female gametophyte, which is embryocyte. Almost every year it is repeatedly asked in the board examinations, and you must practice this topic. Okay, so I ask you all to follow this lecture very carefully and understand each and every point. I have tried to put the things in a very simple schematic way, and I ask you to complete one homework. Actually, you should draw this structure of the female gametophyte, especially the figure 2.8, figure B and figure C. Okay, so these structures you should draw, and it will also be good if you draw at least this structure. Okay, and in the examinations also you will need to draw this, especially this diagram of the mature embryo sac or the female gametophyte. So now we will see what is megasporogenesis. So megasporogenesis is nothing but it is the formation of the megaspores from the megaspore mother cell. Okay, so megasporogenesis involves the process of formation of the megaspores from the megaspore mother cell. So megaspore mother cell yani MMC se megaspores banne ke liye jo process hota hai usko megasporogenesis bolte hai. Very simple hai, इसको आप बहुत अच्छे से डिफाइन कर सकते हो. यू कैन जस्ट राइट डाउन दिस डायग्राम और दिस फ्लो चार्ट, एंड यूजिंग दिस फ्लो चार्ट यू कैन राइट इन योर ओन वर्ड्स अबाउट द डिफिनेशन ऑफ द मेगास्पोरोजेनेसिस. तो मेगास्पोर मदर सेल क्या होता है, कहाँ से आता है और उससे मेगास्पोर कैसे बनते हैं, ठीक है, इसका डिटेल हम मेगास्पोरोजेनेसिस में देखेंगे. तो एज वी ऑलरेडी हैव स्टडीड द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द ओव्यूल इन ग्रेट डिटेल, वी हैड सीन दैट हाउ एन ओव्यूल इज लोकेटेड इन द कैविटी विच इज कॉल्ड एज लोक्यूल इन साइड द ओवरी. राइट, ओवरी के अंदर एक कैविटी होती है जिसको लोक्यूल बोलते हैं. लोक्यूल के अंदर वन और मैनी ओव्यूल्स आर लोकेटेड, एंड दिस ओव्यूल इज अटैच टू द ओवरी थ्रू प्लेसेंटा. राइट, एंड देन प्लेसेंटा से एक स्टॉक लाइक स्ट्रक्चर निकलता है जिसको क्या बोला जाता है, फ्यूनिकल. एंड फ्रॉम द फ्यूनिकल द ओव्यूल इज अटैच्ड, एंड द जंक्शन बिटवीन द फ्यूनिकल एंड ओव्यूल इज कॉल्ड एज हाइलम. राइट, इट ऑल्सो हैज द प्रोटेक्टिव कवरिंग इन द आउटर लेयर ऑफ द ओव्यूल विच आर कॉल्ड एज इंटेगुमेंट्स, एंड एट वन पॉइंट there is this protective layer of integuments missing, and this is a pore-like structure and it is called as micropyle, and that end is called as micropylar end, and the other end is called as chalazal end or chalaza. And we also had seen that the major mass or the main body of the ovule, which is usually covered by the integuments, which are one or two layers. Right, so the main body of the ovule is called as nucellus. Okay, so all that details we already had seen and discussed. Now where this megaspore mother cell arises and what is megaspore mother cell, all those things now we will study over here. These are very simple things. Okay, so just don't panic, don't fear, these are very simple, very systematic things. And if you understand it once, things are settled. Okay, so try to understand it for the first time and note down everything very carefully. If you have any doubt, feel free to ask me and clarify your doubts. Okay, and so what is nucellus? Nucellus is a mass of cells which form the ovule. Okay, so this is the major portion or main body of the ovule, and it is called as nucellus. So what happens that usually one cell from the nucellus region एक्चुअली स्टार्ट्स डिफरेंशिएटिंग, एक्सक्यूज मी लेट मी क्लोज द विंडो, देयर इज सम नॉइज कमिंग, सॉरी फॉर दैट। ओके, सो वन सेल ऑफ द न्यूक्लियस एक्चुअली स्टार्ट्स डिफरेंशिएटिंग एंड दिस सेल बिकम्स लार्ज एंड इट डेवलप्स ए डेंस साइटोप्लाज्म एंड इट हैज़ ए प्रोमिनेंट न्यूक्लियस। सो दिस बिग सेल इन द न्यूक्लियस आफ्टर डिफरेंशिएशन इज कॉल्ड एज MMC और मेगास्पोर मदर सेल। यूजली दिस सेल ऑफ द MMC इन द न्यूक्लियस डेवलप्स एट द माइक्रोपाइलर एंड। ओके, आई थिंक द थिंग्स आर वेरी क्लियर टू यू, राइट? सो नाउ इफ आई शो यू दिस फिगर, इन द फिगर 2.8 ए, हियर यू सी दिस इज द सेल्स ऑफ द न्यूक्लियस। ओके, एंड दिस इज ए लार्ज सेल, elongated cell with a dense cytoplasm and a big nucleus. Okay, so this differentiated large cell with a dense cytoplasm and a large nucleus is called as megaspore mother cell or MMC. In the androecium we had seen PMC or pollen mother cell. Here this is megaspore mother cell or MMC. Okay, so this megaspore mother cell, actually what happens after division, it will form the megaspores. How it forms the megaspores, that we are going to see over here. Okay, so what happens, that meiosis of megaspore mother cell happens, and after meiosis, I think most of you know that meiosis is a reduction division, right? Rather, not most of you, rather all of you should be knowing, because we have studied last year in the detail. So there is meiosis 1 followed by meiosis 2, and then there is cytokinesis. That means the cell will divide and it will make a 4 cells, right? So after meiosis, what will happen? There will be meiosis. So during the meiosis, there will be meiosis 1, which will generate 2 nuclei, and then it will be followed by meiosis 2, and eventually 4 nuclei will be generated. Okay, so first, after meiosis 1, what happens, that 2 cell stages is generated. So after meiosis 1, there is again cytokinesis, that means 2 cells will be created, and this stage is called as dyad stage. Okay, dyad. So here you can see, so there is one MMC, megaspore mother cell, and after meiosis 1, you will have 2 cells, okay, and these are the megaspore dyad. Okay, so why it is dyad? Dyad is because from one cell after meiosis, you have got the 2 cells, okay. So after meiosis 1, you get 2 cells, and these are called as dyad. And after meiosis 2, the meiosis completes, and it forms 4 cells. So these are 4 cells now, and these are called as tetrad. So these are megaspore tetrads. Okay, so 4 cells which are haploid in nature will be formed after the completion of the meiosis of the MMC or megaspore mother cell. Okay, so usually what happens, that one of these cells only will participate in the formation of the female gametophyte. So these 4 megaspores, which are actually haploid, are formed. Okay, megaspore mother cell is diploid, but these megaspores after meiosis, they are haploid. So usually in the flowering plants, what happens, that only one megaspore cell becomes functional, rest 3 megaspores actually degenerate or die. Okay, so they die and they degenerate, wo khatam ho jate hain. So this kind of the process, this kind of the development of the female gametophyte, where only one functional megaspore gives rise to the female gametophyte and rest of the megaspore cells are degenerated, is called as monosporic development. तो मोनोस्पोरिक डेवलपमेंट का मतलब क्या हुआ, जो मेगास्पोर टेट्राड बना है मेगास्पोर टेट्राड में से सिर्फ एक मेगास्पोर सेल एम्ब्रियोसाइक या फीमेल गैमेटोफाइट बनाएगा और रेस्ट ऑफ द थ्री सेल्स विल डिजेनरेट. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज मोनोस्पोरिक डेवलपमेंट. ओके, वेरी सिंपल. नाउ दिस वन फंक्शनल मेगास्पोर सेल विच हैज रिजल्टेड आफ्टर दिस मायोसिस एक्चुअली will undergo a process of development and eventually it will form a female gametophyte which is also called as embryocyte. Okay, female gametophyte ka hi technical term hai, technical naam hai embryocyte. So what is the nature of the embryocyte? Embryocyte is actually a structure at the cellular level and it is a 7-celled stage and having 8 nuclei. Okay, so what is female gametophyte? Female gametophyte is a haploid structure with 7 cells and 8 nuclei, and this figure 2.8c, this is the structure of the embryocyte, mature embryocyte or mature female gametophyte. We will be discussing about it in more detail in this talk only in a few moments. So how this 7-celled and 8-nucleate stage arises, that now we will discuss. So now you have understood what is megasporogenesis, right? How a megaspore mother cell gives rise to megaspores and finally the functional megaspore, and that functional megaspore eventually develops into an embryo sac. Okay, so now let us study the detail and structure and how it is formed about the embryo sac or female gametophyte. So when the functional megaspore is generated after the meiosis, it undergoes a free nuclear division of the mitosis. What is free nuclear division of the mitosis? As you all know that during mitosis, what happens, there is first there is G1 phase, then there is S phase, then there is a G2 phase, right? After G2 phase, what will happen? There will be meiosis or M phase, right? Mitosis or M phase. So during the M phase, there will be again 4 phases, as you all know: prophase, metaphase, anaphase and telophase, right? After the completion of the telophase, you will have two genetically identical cells generated by the process of the mitosis, right? And after this M phase or the telophase has completed, two independent free nuclei will be formed, and it will be followed by cytokinesis. So first there will be karyokinesis, and during the karyokinesis, what will happen? There will be division of the nucleus. From one nucleus, two nucleus will be formed. After the karyokinesis, there will be cytokinesis, that means two cells will be formed. So how two cells will be formed? A cell wall will be laid between the in between, and this is how a separation will be generated and two cells will be created, right? So if the karyokinesis is not followed by cytokinesis, what will happen? There will be two nuclei, but there will not be two cells. There will be two nuclei, but there will be only one cell. So if the cell undergoes one round of the free nuclear mitosis, what will happen? You will have one cell, but it will have two nuclei. Okay, so this kind of division is called as free nuclear division. That means the nucleus is dividing, but the cell is not dividing. That means the cell remains same, the cytoplasm remains intact, it does not divide. Okay, so after the first round of the free nuclear mitotic division or mitosis, two nuclei will be formed, and these nuclei actually will move to the opposite poles or towards the opposite ends in the megaspore which we had started with, right? So here you can see in the figure B. So after the mitosis, two nuclei have generated and they move towards the opposite poles. Then again it will be followed by one more free nuclear mitosis. So from the each nucleus, again two nucleus will be formed. So you have four celled एम्ब्रियोसाइक स्टेज. ओके, सो यू हैव फोर न्यूक्लिएट रदर नॉट, सो इट इट इज़ ए सिंगल सेल बट टू न्यूक्लियस. सो इट इज़ ए टू न्यूक्लिएट एम्ब्रियोसाइक स्टेज. देन आफ्टर वन मोर माइटोसिस यू विल हैव फोर न्यूक्लिएट एम्ब्रियोसाइक स्टेज. देन वन मोर राउंड ऑफ थ्री न्यूक्लियर माइटोसिस विल अकर एंड नाउ यू विल हैव एट न्यूक्लिएट एम्ब्रियोसाइक स्टेज. ओके, सो नाउ आफ्टर द थ्री राउंड्स ऑफ द फ्री न्यूक्लियर माइटोसिस डिवीजन, फर्स्ट माइटोसिस, सेकेंड माइटोसिस एंड थर्ड माइटोसिस, यू हैव एट न्यूक्लिएट एम्ब्रियोसाइक स्टेज विच इज़ फॉर्म्ड. आफ्टर दीज एट न्यूक्लियर आर फॉर्म्ड, नाउ द सेल वॉल विल बी स्टार्टेड टू बी लेड डाउन. सेल वॉल विल स्टार्ट फॉर्मिंग आफ्टर द एट न्यूक्लियाई हैव बीन जनरेटेड. सो दीज सेल वॉल्स नाउ विल बी फॉर्म्ड वेरी इन ए वेरी यूनिक एंड इन ए वेरी डायरेक्टेड मैनर. ओके, सो वाट विल हैपन दैट आउट ऑफ दिस एट न्यूक्लियाई, सिक्स न्यूक्लियाई विल बी सराउंडेड बाई द सेल वॉल्स. ओके, एंड दे विल मेक कंप्लीट सेल्स. दिस विल बी लिटिल मोर क्लियर वंस आई फोकस ऑन द फिगर. ओके, सो सिक्स न्यूक्लियाई विल बी सराउंडेड कंप्लीटली एंड दे विल मेक सेल्स. एंड टू न्यूक्लियाई actually will not be surrounded by the new cells and they will remain in the large cell or which is the central cell and they are called as polar nuclei. So if I show you it here, so these are eight nuclei. Out of these eight nuclei, two nuclei will not get surrounded by the cell wall. These three nuclei at the one end will assemble and they will be surrounded by the cell walls. So here these three cells have been formed inside this larger central cell. Okay, so these two nuclei which are present at the center of this large central cell, they are called as polar nuclei. So there are two polar nuclei and three nuclei have been surrounded by the cell wall at one end and three nuclei will be surrounded by the cell wall at another end. Okay, so the three cells at the micropylar end, actually three cells at the micropylar end, they will be actually forming the egg apparatus. So here if you see, out of these eight nuclei, okay, six nuclei will have the cell walls and two nuclei are polar nuclei, as you have seen now just now in the figure. So from these eight nuclei, three cells at the micropylar end, they will make a specialized structure which is called as egg apparatus. Okay, so if you see over here at the micropylar end, okay, at this end or here, this is the micropylar end, these three nuclei, they are forming the egg apparatus. So these three cells together are called as egg apparatus. So what is egg apparatus? Egg apparatus has actually two cells and then this is one cell. So these two cells are called as synergids or synergid cells. Okay, and then this central cell, this is called as the egg cell. Okay, so there will be one egg cell and two synergid cells in the egg apparatus. Okay, here there is one egg cell and two synergid cell in the egg apparatus. Right, so now these three cells at the micropylar end have made the egg apparatus. Two are called as synergids and one is called as egg cell. And there is one peculiar feature for the synergids, that at the towards the end of the micropylar end, these synergids will have the cell wall which gets thickened. Okay, so this thickened cell wall actually a kind of special cellular thickening is developed and this is called as filiform apparatus. Okay, so this special thickening is called as filiform apparatus. What is function of the filiform apparatus? When the male gamete is coming through the pollen tube towards the egg for fertilization, what will happen, that this filiform apparatus will help, it will guide the pollen tube to pass through it so that the male gamete can reach the egg for fertilization. ओके. सो द फाइली फॉर्म अपैरेटस ऑफ द एग अपैरेटस इन द सिनर्जिड्स प्ले वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल इन गाइडिंग द पोलन ट्यूब इन टू द सिनर्जिड सेल्स एंड देन इवेंचुअली द मेल गैमेट रीचेस द एग. ओके. सो दिस इज अबाउट द दीज थ्री सेल्स एट माइक्रोपाइलर एंड. देन एज वी ऑलरेडी हैव सीन दैट टू सेल्स एट द इन द सेंटर मेक द पोलर न्यूक्लियाई. हेयर इफ यू सी दीज टू सेल्स एट द सेंटर विच वी हैड सीन ओवर हेयर दे आर नॉट सराउंडेड बाई द वॉल एंड दे मेक पोलर न्यूक्लियाई एंड दे आर लोकेटेड एट द सेंटर ऑफ द लार्ज सेल और द सेंट्रल सेल. सो दीज आर टू पोलर न्यूक्लियाई. ओके. देन नाउ दीज थ्री सेल्स रिमेनिंग एट द कलाजल एंड देयर ऑल्सो द सेल वॉल इज लेड डाउन एंड दे फॉर्म द एंटीपोडल्स और एंटीपोडल सेल्स. दीज आर सिनर्जिड सेल्स और सिनर्जिड्स दे आर टू इन नंबर. एंटीपोडल्स आर थ्री इन नंबर. ओके. सो नाउ टोटल हाउ मैनी सेल्स हैव द सेल वॉल फॉर्म्ड. वन टू एंड थ्री. सो थ्री सेल्स हेयर एंड थ्री सेल्स हेयर. सो थ्री सेल्स हैव सेल वॉल्स फॉर्म्ड अराउंड देम. हाउएवर टू न्यूक्लियाई. सो थ्री एंड थ्री सिक्स. सिक्स न्यूक्लियाई हैव सेल वॉल लेड अराउंड देम फ्रेशली एंड दीज टू पोलर न्यूक्लियाई एक्चुअली रिमेन इन द सेंटर ऑफ द लार्ज सेल. देर इज नो फ्रेश सेल वॉल फॉर्म्ड अराउंड देम. इन दिस वे नाउ दिस हैज़ बिकम वन टू थ्री फोर फाइव सिक्स सेवन एट. एट न्यूक्लिएट स्टेज. बट हाउ मैनी सेल्स आर देयर. वन टू थ्री फोर फाइव सिक्स एंड दिस इज द लार्ज सेंट्रल सेल सेवन. सो सेवन सेल स्टेज बट एट न्यूक्लिएट स्टेज. सो दिस इज द कंप्लीट एंड मैच्योर स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द फीमेल गैमेटोफाइट. ओके. सो एट द लास्ट थ्री सेल्स एट द कलाजल एंड फॉर्म द एंटीपोडल्स. सो फाइनली इन दिस वे फ्रॉम द मेगास्पोर मदर सेल. ओके. विच डेवलप्स इन द न्यू सेलस यू हैव इवेंचुअली द फंक्शनल मेगास्पोर आफ्टर मायोसिस एंड दिस फंक्शनल मेगास्पोर आफ्टर सेवरल राउंड्स ऑफ द माइटोसिस एक्चुअली gives rise to the mature male, mature female gametophyte, and mature female gametophyte is a seven-celled, eight-nucleate stage, and it is a haploid structure, and it contains one egg cell, and two polar nuclei, three antipodal cells, and two synergid cells. Okay, so this is all about the female gametophyte and megasporogenesis. This should be very, very clear to you. And feel free to ask me if you have any confusion, if you have any doubt. And don't forget to draw the figures in your notebook. Otherwise, if you don't draw the figure, you will not understand anything. In the examination also, you have to draw this figure. Only then you will get the full marks. And believe me, almost every year, this question is asked. Okay? Repeatedly, almost every year. And once you have understood this megasporogenesis process, we already have discussed about the microsporogenesis process where two-celled or three-celled stage pollen grain was formed. Now here we have a seven-celled stage of the embryo sac formed. Now after you have understood the microsporogenesis and megasporogenesis, then how the male gametophyte reaches to the female gametophyte, that is by the process of called as pollination. So reaching of the pollen from the androecium to gynoecium is called as pollination. And in the next lecture we will study about the pollination and different kinds of pollination which are seen in the huge number of the diverse plants. So after the pollen has reached from androecium to gynoecium, then the pollen must germinate so that the male gametophyte is able to reach the egg. So then we will discuss those processes and then we will study how the fertilization, that means fusion of the male and female gametes, takes place. Okay. So this is a very interesting chapter एंड वेरी इम्पोर्टेंट ऑल्सो, एंड आई थिंक यू ऑल आर एन्जॉइंग दिस लेक्चर. सो नाउ आफ्टर हैविंग डिस्कस्ड द मेगा स्पोरोजेनेसिस एंड स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द एम्ब्रियो सैक, वी विल स्टॉप ओवर हेयर एंड वी विल स्टडी द पॉलिनेशन इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर. ओके, थैंक यू, टेक केयर, बाय बाय.